Football has more money than ever before, and this situation has led to some football clubs entering a perpetual cycle of hiring managers, spending huge sums of money, and when things go awry, sacking the manager and doing it all over again. This endless pursuit of immediate success and lack of stability is the result of poor leadership at clubs, and one way that can be explained is through the concept of game theory. Game theory is a branch of mathematics that also uses elements of sociology and economics to better understand rational decision-making in competitive situations. It's used to understand a wide variety of topics, from business to war. The premise is that when you have more than one competitor in a situation, you have a game. And there are two types of games, finite and infinite. Finite games are defined as having set rules and players in which the objective of the game is to win. An individual football match is a classic example. There are 11 known players on each team and set agreed-upon rules that both teams follow in order to try and win the match. In contrast, infinite games have changeable rules and both known and unknown players. Most importantly, the goal of the game is not to win, but to keep playing. If we examine football in a holistic sense, it becomes clear that it's an infinite game. Nobody can win or lose the entire sport of football. They can only try and continue to be a player amongst a large field of constantly changing players. There is no football club who wins every trophy every season, and there are countless clubs who fade out of relevance at the highest level. In this sense, we can understand that the clubs who are successful are those who recognise the type of game they are in and implement strategies befitting that game. An example of this is Sir Alex Ferguson and Manchester United from 2004 to 2007. United failed to win the league for three successive seasons during that time period, and Ferguson was facing significant pressure from fans and critics who saw Chelsea and Arsenal as the best teams in England. However, Ferguson understood that Manchester United could never be Premier League winners every single year, and that there would be times in his tenure that his squad would be inferior to that of other teams. Rather than trying to immediately sign big-name players to react to his competition, Ferguson understood the benefits of developing talents like Wayne Rooney and Cristiano Ronaldo would outweigh Manchester United's short-term failures. This is not to say that Ferguson didn't care about results, it's simply that he believed in certain ideas about how football should be approached, among which was youth development. Ferguson made decisions based on his and Manchester United's values ahead of their interests. And this type of infinite strategy enabled him to eventually outperform his competition in the long term. A more recent example of a team that recognises it's an infinite game is Watford. Watford are not big spenders in the Premier League, with the likes of Wolverhampton Wanderers, Everton and Fulham spending far more than them in the transfer window. Instead, Watford looks to make astute signings that fit the system the manager is trying to implement and do so with the intent of achieving stability and consistency. Even when events take a turn for the worse, Watford don't become reactionary and instead stay committed to their principles. For instance, at the end of the 17-18 season, Watford lost manager Marco Silva and a huge talent in Richarlison to Everton, who finished 6 places above Watford. In this scenario, it would be easy for a club to spend big to try and plug the gaps in their side. However, Watford appointed a manager who could get the best out of the players in the squad, and have now developed a cohesive and successful side that sit 8th in the Premier League and in contention for Europe. Now, it might seem strange for Watford to take this approach. After all, they'll never get close to winning the league without heavy investment in the squad. But Watford realised that for them, that is not the definition of success. If Watford were to stay a top half Premier League side for the next 15 years and never finish above 5th, that would be an astonishing achievement. Different clubs have different potentials, and Watford's approach has set them on course to become the best version of themselves. One case of a team potentially failing to recognise that they are in an infinite game is Fulham. The London side was sensational in the Championship and earned promotion with the expectation of performing well in the top flight. The side was built on cohesion and an understanding between players to achieve their possession-based attacking style. However, Fulham spent heavily in the transfer window, in an attempt to secure safety by improving the quality of the players in the squad. In doing so, they failed to recognise what had made them successful in the past, and aimlessly sought to achieve safety in the short term. Fast forward to March, Fulham have had 3 different managers and seem destined to go straight back down. Now, there is no guarantee that Fulham would have stayed up had they depended on their existing squad alone, but they would certainly have more stability and long-term assurance than they currently have. It's clear that football is an infinite game because it is in the clubs and the managers who pursue infinite strategies that eventually become great. Managers like Sir Alex Ferguson and Johan Cruyff made Manchester United and Barcelona so successful by consistently making decisions based on their values and thus created sustainability in the long run. And the blueprint for those incredible coaches and teams are clearly rooted in infinite strategies.